Welcome to our presentation this evening. I am Melanie McWhorter, the Development Coordinator here at Historic Santa Fe Foundation, and currently in our offices here at El Zaguan. We are open, pending any health orders, from 9 to noon Monday through Friday, and we currently have Ed Epping's show hanging in our Sala space, but you can also see some of his work online at historicsantafe.org if you want to check some of it out there too. But you're also welcome to come and visit us. Just wear a mask, and we're limiting it to 5 people at a time, but come by and see us. We have more events that are going to be coming up with the SALON events in 2021. So if you haven't already signed up for our newsletter, if you would sign up for our newsletter online at historicsantafe.org, and you can find out everything that we have coming up. It is no charge for members and $10 drop-in rate for the Zoom events. So we hope that you'll take a look at our upcoming schedules. The event this evening is a fundraiser for Historic Santa Fe Foundation, but the board and staff had chosen to make a contribution as well with some of the monies that come in. So we're splitting all of the monies that come in for this for the Empty Stocking Fund, which is a fund that provides support for housing assistance, car repairs, home heating, utility bills, and et cetera for people in need. And it's managed by the Santa Fe Community Foundation. So you can find out a little bit more there if you would like to as well. And now I am really pleased to introduce our speaker and performer for this evening, Rob Martinez, a state historian. There he is. But one thing I wanted to tell you too before I introduce Rob is that we'll have questions near the end. Rob will perform. He has his song list that he's already going to perform for us. And we will have have questions for him at the end that will be allowed through the chat window. The chat window, I'm going to change that to where it is all panelists and attendees. So everyone can post something there. If you would keep the chats to a minimum at that point, because we are going to read out the questions near the end. So I don't want any kind of comments maybe getting lost in that. And I'll read out all the questions to Rob because we're going to be recording this evening. Also, when he starts to perform, he should fill the screen. If not, there is an option for changing your view. Usually it's up in the right-hand corner of Zoom. So you can change how you're viewing the screen at that point. So now it's my pleasure to welcome Rob Martinez, our state historian. Rob is a native New Mexican, born and raised in Albuquerque. He is a graduate of the University of New Mexico with a B.B.A. in International Business Management. He earned an MA in Latin American history with an emphasis on church, cultural, and social practices of the Spanish colonial period in New Mexico. And as it relates to tonight's presentation, Rob Martinez is also a folk musician, performing and promoting New Mexico's Hispanic musical traditions for the past 20 years with his brother Lorenzo and his father Roberto Martinez in the group Los Reyes de Albuquerque. With his musical family, he has performed in all parts of New Mexico and on multiple occasions has presented music at the New Mexico and New Mexico culture at the Smithsonian Folk Life Festival in Washington, D.C., the NEA's National Heritage Fellowship Awards, and also at the Kennedy Center for the Performing Arts. So we welcome our presenter for this evening, state historian Rob Martinez. Thanks, Rob.
Thank you.
Hasta la mañana en que vengo a saludarles. Venimos todos con gusto y placer a felicitarles. El día en que tú naciste, nacieron todas las flores. De la pila del bautismo cantaron los ruiseñores. Ya viene amaneciendo, ya la luz el día nos dio. Levántate de mañana, miran que ya amaneció. santo, te deseamos felicidades. Con jazmines y flores, este día voy a adornar. Hoy, por ser día de tu santo, te venimos a cantar.
Hello. Hola. Welcome. Bienvenidos. Welcome to New Mexico. I'm Rob Martinez, State Historian of New Mexico and Albuquerque-based musician. It's really great to be here for such a cool event. I know you're all over, but for tonight, you're in Nuevo Mexico, in New Mexico. So on behalf of a historic Santa Fe, the Office of the State Historian, and New Mexico State Record Center and Archives, welcome. I'm going to be doing a music presentation tonight dealing with our Hispano New Mexican music, a little bit of history just so we can get the scholastic part out of the way. New Mexico was Puebloan first and still is. Pueblo people were here first for about between 12 and 15,000 years ago they came. Then we became part of colonial Mexico under the Spanish system in 1598 and remained in that system until 1821, and then we became part of the Mexican nation. Then in 1848, we became a territory of the United States, and then a state in 1912. So keep that in mind, all the different peoples and cultures, Puebloan, Genízaro Indian, Comanche, Apache, Navajo, Mexican, Portuguese, French, American, Jewish, Muslim, African influences, all of these peoples are blending over the centuries and creating culture, language differences in New Mexico compared to other Spanish-speaking places. And our music here is a mix of all of these peoples. So I'm gonna sing a song now called A Medias de la Noche. We sing this in my family. This goes out to my sister Doris, who's in Denver, Colorado, and it's called A Medias de la Noche. In the middle of the night.
A medias de la noche te soñaba abrazándote conmigo, te soñaba abrazándote conmigo. Es el amor. Despierta, mamacita, ya no duermas. Despierta, ese sueño seductor. Tomaremos copas llenas de licor. Pero hay
A medias de la noche. So much of our music is from Mexico. Mexican music is our folk music, but we also have our own homegrown music here that evolved through the decades and the centuries through religion, through folklore, through folk music. I'm going to chant an alabado. An alabado is a hymn that the penitentes, this is a lay brotherhood from New Mexico that developed out of a shortage of priests in New Mexico in the late 1700s and early 1800s. And they are not priests, they are not monks, they are married men or single men in towns who have chapels called moradas. And they go and they pray and chant and help the local communities through difficult times in a community's life. So this is a alabado called Adios Acompañamiento. There's no instrumentation. These are chanted a cappella. And this is about the realities of life and death and looking back on one's journey through this world. Adiós, acompañamiento. Donde me estaban velando. Ya se llegó la hora y tiempo de que me vayan sacando. Adiós, mis amados padres que conservaban mi vida. Ya se llegó la hora y tiempo. Ya se llegó mi partida. ¿Qué corazones no sienten tan solo en considerar que este paso tan amargo todos lo tienen que andar? La sepultura es mi cama, la tierra mi propio ser. Se me atemoriza el alma de considerar mi anhel. Adiós todos mis parientes, toditos en general. Encomienden mi alma a Dios, no me vayan a olvidar. That's an alabado, chanted sometimes in a morada or sometimes just during processions through a town. Very solemn, very profound. Now I'm going to present to you an indita. Inditas are a type of homegrown New Mexican songs from the same period, the late 1700s or the early 1800s. And these songs came out of Spanish folk music traditions brought during the colonial period, and they evolve in New Mexico to inditas. Inditas means a little Indian girl. We're not sure why. I think it's because it blends. It's mestizo music. It's mixed. Pueblo and Genízaro and Hispanic, Mexican, Spanish. It's a pretty deep blend. So this is one that's a cautiva about a woman. They usually are, and they're from a woman's perspective. It's an Indita de Placida Romero. She was a woman who lived out near Grants, New Mexico, near Acoma Pueblo. And in the 1800s, towards the middle or later part of the 1800s, there was a raid on her town. Cubero, Cebolla, and the Apaches attacked and killed the men, or some of the men, and took women and children, never to be seen again. She was taken down to Mexico. And this is a song that took place. They're historic. It says it takes place on the day of San Lorenzo. It's a feast day, probably around the 11th of August. It even says around 10:30 in the morning this happened, and she loses her husband, Jesus Maria. And in the chorus, she says goodbye to her daughters, never to see them again. And in the second verse, she really lets the town have it. What happened? Where was all the bravery? Where were all the valiant men to protect us? So these are very incredible old songs. This is La Indita de Plácida Romero.
El día de San Lorenzo fue un día muy poderoso que me llevaron. Cuando les volverá a ver, las esquivar. Los palos, las piedras lloran de verme salir cautiva. Adiós, cubero afamado, se te acabó el valiente. Quizás no tenía parte o te ha faltado la gente. Adiós, ya me voy, voy a padecer. Adiós, mis queridas hijas, cuando les volver a ver.
Some of these songs, when I play them, I hear all the influences. You can hear Puebloan or Genisaro rhythm, Spanish words and themes, but even sometimes some melodies that sound very Semitic, going back to Moorish or Jewish times in Spain, or even American cowboy music. Sometimes that one always struck me a little bit as having that cowboy feel, and it might be a mix with that influence from the 1860s to the 1880s. All right. I'm going to sing some more religious music because growing up, we used to, and still do, but you know, with COVID, everything's kind of shut down, right? But I was preparing for this presentation. I was thinking of music I used to hear going to church with my parents. We'd go to San Jose Parish in the southern part of Albuquerque to the Mexican part of town where a lot of immigrants from Mexico. And my dad got along great with them because, well, we are also Mexican-American deeply here in New Mexico. So we used to hear this beautiful song called Bendito, Bendito. And I'm going to sing this one without any instrument, just a cappella. Bendito, bendito, bendito sea Dios. Los ángeles cantan y alaban a Dios. Los ángeles cantan y alaban a Dios. Yo creo, Jesús mío, que estás en el altar. Oculto en la hostia, te vengo a adorar. Oculto en la hostia, te vengo a adorar. Jesús, Rey del Cielo, que está en el altar, su cuerpo, su sangre nos da sin cesar. Su cuerpo, su sangre nos da sin cesar. Bendito, bendito, bendito sea Dios. Los ángeles cantan y alaban a Dios. Los ángeles cantan y alaban a Dios. These were the kind of songs we sang through our religious, cultural expression. And then afterwards, we might stop if we were lucky. Mom and Dad would take us to Mr. Donut to get some donuts, and then home to have some frijoles, chile, tortillas, and if we were lucky again, maybe some natillas. Now, this is a Mexican, New Mexican food. Another Indita I want to sing, it talks about the hard and harsh life in New Mexico in the 1700s and 1800s. Pueblo, Genisaro, and Nuevo Mexicano people, they would hunt buffalo. They'd go together often. They were difficult animals to kill. They're huge. They had horses that were trained to ride alongside the buffalo, and then they would lance them to kill it. And then the horse was trained to move so that when the animal fell, it wouldn't fall on the horseman or the horse and kill them. Well, this poor guy, Manuel Maez, he was a Nuevo Mexicano. He went out to the Llanos east of Las Vegas, New Mexico, and he was hunting with his friends, and his horse did something wrong, turned the wrong direction, and instead he was impaled on the lance. And so this is an Indita called La Indita de Manuel Maez, which talks about his passing and his saying goodbye to the places he knew, the roads, the stopping places, his family, his mom and dad are mentioned. These are real people. and his novia, his bride-to-be, he has to say goodbye to. It goes like this.
Caballo en la santo estado, que tú la muerte me diste. Caballo en la santo estado, que tú la muerte me diste. Me vi de tan fatigado, desamparado y tan triste. Me vi de tan fatigado, desamparado y tan triste. Caballo prieto mentado, que tú la muerte me diste. Caballo prieto mentado, que tú la muerte me diste. Tu cuerpo quedó bañado con mi sangre que teniste. Tu cuerpo quedó bañado con mi sangre que teniste. Adiós todos los parajes que en el camino encontré. Adiós todos los parajes que en el camino encontré. Adiós madre Donaciana y padre Juan de Dios Mes. Adiós mis padres queridos, no me verán otra vez. Adiós mi novia querida, ay qué bonita te ves. Adiós mi novia querida, ay qué bonita te ves. Adiós hermanos y hermanas, no me verán otra vez. Adiós parientes queridos, del finado Manuel Mes. Del finado Manuel Mes.
Indita de Manuel Maez. That Indita has about 32 or 34 verses. I just did a short version. We don't have time to do the whole thing, right? But it's interesting. Some of the verses, in one of the verses, he actually lets his friend, he has a friend named Salvador Tapia, who he lets have it. He says something like, wow, you know, you just left me to die next to the river on the riverbank. Thanks a lot. Thanks for that. And I've done my genealogy, and it turns out that on my mom's side, we trace back to Salvador Tapia, that guy who left his friend supposedly. So he's immortalized in that song, Indita de Manuel Maez. Another type of song in New Mexico in the late colonial period and then into the Mexican period were alabanzas. Alabanzas were also hymns. These were sung by everyone, men, women, children, and they were sung usually in the field when harvesting was going on, sembrando, and it was to, you know, keep a rhythm going. And so I'm going to sing this is the alabanza to San Isidro Labrador. San Isidro is one of New Mexico's patron saints. You can see him everywhere in santos and in churches. And he's the patron of farmers, and New Mexico is very much a rural place for centuries. So this is San Isidro Labrador. I love this because they ask for his protection for their work and their food, but also protection against the thief from stealing their food, the fruits of their labor.
San Isidro Labrador, patrón de los labradores, liberta nuestra sembrado de vientos y de temblores. Por el gran merecimiento con que te adora el Señor, nuestro sembrado, San Isidro Labrador. Por el sudor y trabajo con que fuiste fatigado, San Isidro Labrador, verse about the thief. Del ladrón acostumbrado y sin temor al Señor. Liberta nuestro sembrado, San Isidro Labrador. Tempestades y granizo que daña nuestra labor.
It's an alabanza. Again, these were sung usually a cappella while everyone was working, kind of like what you heard in the South, where slaves would sing gospel songs while they worked. Similar, the people here weren't slaves, but some of them were the Genízaro Indians, but these were songs that were sung to keep rhythm and keep time. It's usually they're a cappella, although I'm sure there might have been a guitar player there in the old census records from the like around 1750 and 1790. Every once in a while, you'll see a man listed as a músico, a musician. So maybe that guy got to sit under a tree playing the guitar and accompanying everyone while they sang these songs. So that's San Isidro Labrador. Well, now I want to move into our Mexican period, because we have a strong connection to Mexico because of the Camino Real and the Chihuahua Trail, just like we're connected in the 1800s to the United States with the Santa Fe Trail. So I'm gonna sing a corrido, just like we had inditas in New Mexico. In Mexico, corridos, ballads developed out of the Spanish folk music tradition. And these corridos were usually about heroic figures or the history of towns or special magnificent events like the Mexican Revolution. There are even corridos to guns. The type of gun some of these revolutionaries used. I'm gonna sing a corrido my late father, Roberto Martinez, composed about Daniel Fernandez, a Nuevo Mexicano from Los Lunas, New Mexico, who died fighting for the United States in Vietnam in 1966. This is an homage to him. But it's also an homage to all the New Mexican men, Nuevo Mexicanos, who have fought for this country through the decades, starting in 1850 and the Civil War. There were two battles here, two Civil War battles in New Mexico in 1862, one at Valverde. The Union lost to the Confederates, but then at Glorieta, the Union beat the Confederates. So this is to all those soldados, soldiers. This is the corrido de Daniel Fernandez.
Amigos, vengo a cantarles el corrido de un paisano. Se llamó Daniel Fernández, hijo nuevo mexicano. Este soldado valiente, valiente de nuestro estado, por el amor a su patria, la vida sacrificado. Su vida fue terminada, murió en batalla mortal. Ahora se encuentra con Dios en su reino celestial. En el pueblo de los Lunas fue el lugar donde nació. De corazón y a su patria querida la sirvió con devoción. Nuevo México querido, no des el brazo a torcer, tiene soldados valientes que cumplen con su deber. Dijo este gran soldado cuando se vio mal herido, Virgencita milagrosa, no más un favor te pido. Dame un momento de vida para rezarte un rosario. Después, madrecita mía,
El Corrido de Daniel Fernandez. That's one of many corridos my father wrote. He wrote one about the courthouse raid in Tierra Maria in 1967. My dad was friends with Reyes López Tijerina, and when those events took place, my dad immediately wrote a corrido and recorded it with his group Los Reyes de Albuquerque, and then it was on the radio. And when Reyes was taken in, they captured him. When they walked him through the jail yard, Corrido de Rio Arriba, my dad's corrido, was blasting through the speakers in honor of Reyes. So I love that story. I'm going to sing a Mexican song now. It's world famous, but in my family, we all had to sing it. We were little kids. My dad would say, anda, anda, he'd say to me and my sister Debbie, cantan, you have to sing for your tío, your tía, or your primo. So we all learned this one. It's called Los Laureles. You can sing along with me if you know it.
Ay, que laureles tan verdes, que rosas tan encendidas. Si piensas abandonarme, mejor quítame la vida. Alza los ojos a verme, si no estás comprometida. Eres manta de algodón que vives en el capullo. Ay, qué tristeza me da cuando te llenas de orgullo de ver a mi corazón enredado con el tuyo. Eres rosa de Castilla, solo en mayo se ve. Quisiera hacerte un invite, pero la verdad no sé. Si tienes quien te lo evite, mejor te separaré. Por hoy va la despedida, chinita, por tus quereres. La perdición de los hombres son las bonitas mujeres. Aquí se acaban cantando los versos de los laureles.
Los Laureles, made world famous even more so by Linda Ronstadt, who is part Mexican-American, and she got a lot of training singing these kinds of songs, rancheras and ballads and... That's where she got that falsetto for doing Blue Bayou. Blue Bayou. That came from Mexico, from the German people who brought their yodeling there, and that mixes in down there. So see, we're a mix of all kinds of people from all over the world. So that's Los Laureles. Okay, let's sing a really cool song now. This was written by Cleofes Vigil. This is a song, it's an indita. He wrote this about the mixing of cultures in New Mexico, Spanish, Comanche, Pueblo, Genizaro, all of these different peoples. If you hear an echo, it's my reverb to give some presence to the guitar and voice. This is a song he wrote it's an amazing tribute to our mixed culture here. And it's called Himno del Pueblo de las Montañas de la Sangre de Cristo. Pueblo is a word applied to the native people of New Mexico because when the Spanish came, they have organized towns. A pueblo is a town. If you go to Spain, a pueblo is a town. My dad uses the word Pueblo de los Lunas. Los Lunas isn't an Indian pueblo, it's a town in New Mexico. Well, it can also mean people, the population or the people. So the Himno del Pueblo means the hymn of the people of the Blood of Christ Mountains of New Mexico. And this one goes like this.
Españoles la España esta tierra, ondearon sus querencias y hermosas indias morenas, ea, 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 ah. Aquellas indias hermosas, virtuosas, llenas de gracia, escogieron para esposas donde nació linda raza, ea, 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 ah. Raza buena y amarosa, color bronce de mestizo, mezcla del indio del pueblo, donde salió un genizaro, ea, 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 ah. Con sus cantos penetrantes y sus cuadros espirituales, alaban la santa tierra, que para todos es la madre, ea, 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 ah. Ya se oye en los campos aquel canto, aquella danza, retumbaban la montaña, que sangre de Cristo llamaban, ea, 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 ah. Españoles y cumanches, todos en armonía, se juntaban a cantar y a bailar con alegría, ea, 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 ah. Comiendo elotes tostados que la tierra producía, machucando carne seca, de cibolo quería, ea, 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 ah.
Himno del Pueblo. I really love that song. Well, now I'm going to do another kind of New Mexico song. This is a more modern tune coming into the 20th century. My dad's group, Los Reyes de Albuquerque, recorded this song in the early 70s with then Lieutenant Governor Roberto Mondragon. It's a beautiful song about New Mexico. It's called Así es Nuevo México. It's the Spanish language state song, essentially. And in it, it just talks about this beautiful land, the golden colors of the fields, the beautiful women of New Mexico, the Rio Grande, the flowers of May. It's a beautiful song, and this goes out to all of you, okay? Así es Nuevo México.
Canto que traigo muy dentro del alma, lo canto a mi estado, mi tierra natal. De flores dorada, mi tierra encantada, de lindas mujeres que no tiene igual. El río del norte, que es el Río Grande, sus aguas corrientes fluyen hasta el mar. Y riegan tus campos, mi tierra encantada, de lindas mujeres que no tiene igual. Así es Nuevo México, así es esta tierra del sol, de sierras y valles, de tierras vitales, así es Nuevo México. Sus campos se visten de flores de mayo, de lindos colores que Dios les dotó. Tus pájaros cantan mi tierra encantada, sus trinos de amores al ser celestial. Canto que traigo muy dentro del alma, lo canto a mi estado, mi tierra natal. De flores doradas, mi tierra encantada, de lindas mujeres que no tiene igual. Así es Nuevo México, así es esta tierra del sol, de sierras y valles, de tierras frutales, así es Nuevo México.
Así es Nuevo México. All right. Well, you know, this carries us into the modern period, and I'm going to finish up my presentation right now. I'm not going anywhere. We're going to have some talking after this, but I want to thank you all. Muchas gracias. Thank you for your support, and thank you for being here. I'm going to finish with a holiday song made famous by Jose Feliciano. Jose Feliciano, world famous singer, songwriter. In the 1960s, my dad's group, Los Reyes de Albuquerque, they got to go to Hollywood and open for Jose at the Hollywood Palladium. So I'm gonna sing this holiday song for you all. Sing along, please. Feliz Navidad, Feliz Navidad, Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad. I want to wish you a Merry Christmas. I want to wish you a Merry Christmas. I want to wish you a Merry Christmas from the bottom of my heart. Wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas from the bottom of my heart. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad, Feliz Navidad, prospero año y felicidad. Feliz Navidad, happy Christmas, happy Hanukkah, have a great Kwanzaa, whatever your spiritual leanings, have a great holiday. There you go.
Yay, thanks so much, Rob. I was singing. You don't want to hear me sing, though. But
sure, why not? Of course I do.
Yeah, no, we you don't. Do. I'm sure there were lots of other people singing, too, though. That was fantastic. Thanks so much. There is one question, and so, and then there may be others that kind of roll in, as it does tend to happen that way. And then if not, I have a couple others, and then we could have you maybe sing a song or two.
Of course.
Or if there's like a request. I don't want to put in too many requests.
If I can do it, I will. If not,
yeah,
I'll do something else.
Yeah, so John Rogers asks, were the oldest songs performed on the guitar?
What are the oldest songs performed on guitar in New Mexico or just in...
No, were some of the oldest songs performed on the guitar? I guess maybe asking about what instruments, maybe they had a guitar accompaniment.
Yeah, we know from documents that in the early 1600s when the Franciscan priest came to... convert or try to convert the Pueblo people, they brought musical instruments. So we know they had things like guitars, violins, trumpets. They brought drums and cymbals. And I think a couple of churches even had organs back then. So we know that these instruments were around. So the guitar and violin evolve in New Mexico into the 1800s as the instruments of choice for performing New Mexico's folk music. So we know that there were guitars right from the get-go that were brought up from Mexico and probably even from Spain, but there were guitar makers, luthiers in Mexico City by the 1500s and the 1600s, no doubt there had to be. So New Mexico's had guitars since the 1600s for sure.
We'll see if anyone else wants to post any questions, put them in the chat box. And I was just kind of interested too, when you're, because it seems like you know a good bit about musical history as well. Like, how does that go along with studying and researching history just in general? Like, how do you go about incorporating that in? Or is that something that you kind of think about? Like, I had one class that it was just an online class, and his thread that kind of followed through was very much an economic view of history. And he followed sure. that in a line of whatever trade routes. So do you kind of use music as a guide, or how does that fit into your research?
Well, as state historian and just studying at the graduate level, you look at all kinds of ways to look at history. We look at history economically, look at the mercantile system, mercantilism, and you know how slavery impacts the local economies or the encomienda system. So you have to do that economic and social history. But when you start looking at things like music or alabados, the penitente hymns, or dichos, you know, the dime con quien andas y te digo quien eres. Show me who you hang out with and I'll tell you who you are. These dichos, these are folkloric. They say folklore is the poetry of history. So I would just say that music is the music of history, right? I mean, it does kind of fit in. The only challenge is you don't really have any official documentation about music, things like music or other cultural expressions, because they just arrive with people and they just evolve and change and they pick up whatever comes along. You know, our music isn't just one thing. It's not just colonial. It's not just a Mexican period. It's a mix. It has American influences. So you can actually kind of gauge it, but it's hard to separate it out. Do you see what I'm saying? Because a song is it's kind of like a pancake. You know, when you make pancake batter, you get the flour, the baking soda, you throw in some baking, some sugar, maybe some eggs. You mix it all up really, and then you cook it. And then it's almost like saying, well, now I want to take the eggs out. You know what I mean? It's hard to, you can't, it's too mixed already in. So music is kind of like that. It's really hard to tell, you know? I mean, you can hear in some of the melodies, you know. Caballo santo estado, que tú la muerte me diste. That's a lament. That's a very sad song. But you know, it's a mystery to me why a song like the Patasida Romero being a cautiva, it's a horrible story. She's taken captive in it. That was a back and forth thing. Comanche warriors would kill Nuevo Mexicano men and take women and children. And then Nuevo Mexicanos would go out to the Llanos and kill them and take their women and children. It was a back and forth thing, but that's such a... El día de San Lorenzo fue un día muy poderoso. I think that has to have some kind of cowboy feel, but I'm not sure. You know, there's no official documents for these things, so you have to just kind of, you have to listen. That's the part about music. A lot of it's how does it feel to you? What does the listening do? You know, the alabado, adiós acompañamiento, donde me estaban sacando. You know, that's probably a mix of a lot of this idea of penitentes came from Durango, Mexico, but they find it in Spain and the Philippines, and then the Genisaro people are penitentes, and so are the Nuevo Mexicanos. So these songs have melodies that are a mix, just like our Spanish is. Our Spanish is a mix. It's not one thing to say our Spanish is frozen in time from the 1600s. That freezes us in time and it makes our culture dead. It's not a dead culture, it's a living culture. Our Spanish is from Spain, but it's filtered through Mexico with Nahua words, with Puebloan words and Genízaro words and pronunciation from Spain and from Mexico and from Genízaros and from Puebloan. But there's no official documentation. It just gets handed down generation to generation because our music tradition is an oral tradition. It's handed down from generation to generation.
Well, you've got a few more questions. We're ready for some
more. Let's do it.
Douglas Conwell says, do you know anything about Soterios?
Soterios?
Soterios, a version of hammered dulcimer in Mexico. Did it come to New Mexico?
I know what that is. It's an instrument. And I don't know if it has. I mean, here's the thing. Like I said, everything isn't recorded. And, you know, northern New Mexico isn't the only New Mexico. We have southern New Mexico, too. Places like Mesilla, Deming, Lordsburg, Las Cruces, Doña Ana. So there's a heavier Mexican influence there. So it wouldn't surprise me if you find some of the more common instruments from Mexico showing up there. And it doesn't mean they don't show up here. I'm not sure, though. I can't say for certain that it did. But, you know, sometimes you hear this New Mexico music, and I say guitar and violin, but sometimes there's flute, sometimes there's drums. The Zebulon Pike diary from 1807, that's the late colonial period. He says when he was stopping in the pueblos, the priests would feed him, and there was music. He said, there's always music. There's always violin, and there's drums, and there's cymbals, and probably guitars, too. He just didn't mention it. And who knows what else? So music is being played, and they're playing whatever instruments are around.
Yeah, and I would think if there was trade coming back and forth, that there would most definitely
be. Sure, yeah. There's sometimes mandolin shows up on this in this music, and the mandolin might come from Mexico. It might be brought from St. Louis, Missouri. You know, who knows? Musicians just go everywhere and play everything and don't really think too much about, you know, they say, I like that. I'm going to add that to my repertoire.
Well, we have a few more questions, and I think we have to cut off after these if we are able to get to these. We're going to try to wrap up at 6, but we can go over a little bit longer if people want to stick around a little bit.
Sure.
You're free. James Redmond says, is there a difference in the old music in Santa Fe between the music from Mexico and the music from Spain?
I'm not sure I understand the question. I mean, Santa Fe was established between 1608 and 1610, and it was the political and religious center of New Mexico for a long time, then Santo Domingo with the friars, the Franciscans. Music was being brought here from Spain, but it was being brought by people who were in Mexico. So yeah, it's coming up here. Mexican music is coming up here too. I mean, it's all a blend. Look at mariachi. It has the guitar is a European instrument with Moorish roots. But the guitarrón, the big bass, that's kind of an amalgam of European guitar making and native Mexican instrumentation. And the same thing with the little vihuela. That's, you find that in Mexico. And these instruments really start to come up here in the early to mid 1900s. So, I recently did a talk with Enrique La Madrid, that we did a presentation about flamenco in New Mexico and mariachi and, you know, Spain and Mexico. Well, Mexican mariachi is relatively late period, late 1800s. And then it comes up here in the mid 1900s through movies, radio, immigrants. And the same thing with flamenco. We don't have flamenco here in the 1800s or 1700s. It's brought by immigrants or usually New Mexicans going to Mexico City or Spain and falling in love with that music and dance and singing and bringing it to New Mexico, people like Maria Benitez and others. So that all becomes part of us. But in New Mexico, they had fandangos. These were rough and ready dances and guitar and violin music, probably pretty fast, you know, a lot of polkas brought from the Germans in Mexico and the United States, and, you know, women and men dancing close. And for some of the people, whether it was the Catholic bishop and then Archbishop Jean-Baptiste Lamy, he was shocked. he was shocked. He wrote, he goes, there's a lot of immorality here. And a lot of the Puritan Protestants that came here from back east were also shocked. And then they took part a little bit. But, you know, you have that mixing. It's a frontier. It's a rough-hewn place with rough-hewn, rough music, rough people, rough Spanish, rough everything, you know. The food here was not quite as refined as what you would find in Mexico City or Zacatecas, so.
Okay, well, a couple more. Let's see. Lucinda says, where do you think is the best place to hear live alabados when we can gather again?
At a Penitente Morada. When my sister Debbie passed away and my father passed away, the Penitentes from Chacon up in Mora, they came all the way down and they chanted the rosary. That's a very sad event, but that's a place to hear the Penitentes. And they don't do, sometimes they might do a public event, but they don't tend to do performances. I remember there was a presentation at the cathedral in Santa Fe where they had Penitentes. It might've been for a Holy Week. That's when they really do their whipping and chanting and the beautiful, beautiful, but it was underground for so long because the Americans thought it was weird and so did the Catholics who weren't from here. They didn't think it was very Catholic or it was a little strange to them. So that's one way. I'll tell you right now, if you Google Alabados, Penitente Alabados, you can listen on YouTube, not Google, go to YouTube and you can hear them. Sometimes I play them with the Mozarabe chants from Spain. I actually open them in two windows and play them on top of each other. It's quite amazing.
Okay, yeah, that's kind of YouTube. There's a wealth of things. It's like we have a lot of stuff up there too. Okay, so do you have a specific example of Jewish influences in Hispanic folk music?
There's a lot of, well, first of all, the Sephardic Jews have their own folk music from Spain, and then they let the ones that left in 1492 when they were expelled, they're not the ones we descend from. They're the ones who stayed Sephardic, so they have their own tradition. So it's hard to find songs that come down that are Sephardic Jewish because you weren't supposed to be Jewish anymore. You were a converso in that time period, and then after that you were Catholic, and if you were secretly practicing your Jewish faith, you were called a Judaizante, a Judaizer. You couldn't be a converso 100 years later. That would have been your great grandfather or grandmother. You're no longer a convert. You are outwardly, or you know, you're a Catholic, but you still have these cultural attributes, or you're still Jewish, but secretly. It was illegal to be anything except Catholic in the the Spanish Empire. It was the state religion. So you know, but there are songs. Delgadina is one of the oldest ones. I haven't done that one in a long time. It goes, Delgadina se pasaba en su cuadra bien cuadrada con su manto y lo de oro. That's an old song that goes back to the colonial times, but there's a Jewish version of that that has a different ending. I don't recall what it is. I think in one, the girl dies, Delgadina, and the other, she lives. I think in the Jewish one, she lives. In the Catholic one, she dies and goes to heaven. Very Catholic, very Spanish.
Yeah. Okay, let's see. Is there any tradition of the student tuna singing groups in New Mexico?
Not that I'm aware of. The tunas, those are, if you go to Salamanca, Spain, or if you're in Madrid and you sit on the Plaza Mayor of Madrid or Salamanca, which I've done many times. These are groups that come along and they dress in kind of Baroque costumes with hats, and they might have a guitar, they usually have a guitar, they might have a mandolin or a lute or the old vihuela. Vihuela, I mentioned the vihuela, the Mexican vihuela is the little guitar, the little treble guitar that the mariachis use. But in the word actually comes from Spain. A vihuela is either a 6 or 12 string medieval instrument that the Moors brought to Spain. So they play these instruments and they sing songs, they sing romantic songs and kind of comic songs. And they modernized. Last time I was there, they were singing Mexican songs too. They'll do, you know. De la Sierra Morena, cielito lindo, vienen bajando. Un par de ojitos negros, cielito lindo de contrabando. Ay, 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 canta y no llores, porque cantando se alegra, cielito lindo, los corazones. They'll do that, you know, and you're like, wow, Spanish tuna doing Mexican. So everyone's kind of moving up and modernizing, you know. I don't think I've ever seen that here or known of it here. To my knowledge, that's not a New Mexican tradition. It could become one, though.
Yeah, there you go. Maybe you could start that. I have one more question, and then maybe you can take us out. But maybe this will be something that'll lead us out, and then you'll have to really excuse my Spanish. I may slaughter this.
It's okay.
I apologize, Blair Carnham, for this one. She says, are Spanish Christmas carols sung in New Mexico, like Brincan e Balan los Pecos en el Rio?
I don't know if you mean Spanish from Spain or just if we have songs in Spanish. I mean, we do have, we have songs such as the Las Posadas, you'll say, vamos todos a Belén con amor y gozo. You know, vamos todos a Belén. Belén is not just a town south of Isleta Pueblo in New Mexico. That Belén means Bethlehem. So vamos todos a Belén. When I was a little kid, I used to think, oh, we're all going to Belén just south of Albuquerque. But it means let's go to Bethlehem. And so we have those kinds of songs, but we don't do any of the more modern ones. It doesn't mean there's isn't anyone who does them. I mean, my friend, my good friend Nicolasa Chavez, she's a curator at the Museum of International Folk Art. She's also an amazing flamenco dancer and singer, and she's written a book on the history of flamenco in New Mexico. So she's really up on that. She actually, they put out a CD of music that is flamenco Christmas music. But again, that's music from Spain that's being transplanted here. So,
well, that's all the questions we have right now. I would love to just say thank you to everybody for attending. And
thank
then
you.
Do you want to just, and happy holidays from the foundation. We're delighted that Eero was here and we're delighted you're here. Do you want to maybe just take us out with one last song?
Of course. Well, thank you for having me. Muchas gracias. Thank you all for being here. New Mexico music history wouldn't be complete without Buddy Holly, who is from Lubbock, Texas, but recorded most of his hits in Clovis, New Mexico, including this one, which influenced John Lennon, Paul McCartney, and George Harrison. Their first recording was this song. So we kind of helped create the Beatles, right? Right. Here you go.
Well, that'll be the day when you say goodbye. Ah, day when you make me cry, oh, you say you're gonna leave, you know it's a lie, cause that'll be the day when I die, oh, you gave me all your loving and all your turtle loving and all your hugs and kisses and your money too, you say you love me baby and then you tell me maybe, well that someday when I'll be blue, well that'll be the day when you say goodbye, oh, that'll be the day. When I die, oh, that'll be the day. Ooh, that'll be the day. Come on, sing with me. Ooh, that'll be the day. Yeah, you. Ooh, that'll be the day. When I die. There you go, Buddy Holly.
Yay. Thanks so much. Thanks so much, Rob. Thanks, everyone, thank for you. Attending. And happy holidays.
Adios. Hasta pronto.
Adios.